Fire! you very much.
Okay, but of course, in any gathering, in any anniversary celebration at the Commission Audit, we give acknowledgement to the real people, to the real people. We start always from the heart. And I will start introducing the region that is closest to my heart. This is the region that is home to me and my family. But more importantly, this is the region that still believes in miracles. Okay, so I am acknowledging 191 strong delegation headed by yours truly and ARD Dr. Grace Guillen, the Violet Team, Region 9. Okay, we move on to the next delegation. From the region headed by director Celso Bacal, my very good friend, my best friend, and attorney ARD Jerry Mero. He would like to emphasize that this is the Northern Mindanao, in the center of which is the city of Golden Friendship. Tama ba? The Green Team, Region 10! thank you. The next region. Agabi ko ang limelight sa regional director, no? This is the region, I cannot help but reminisce, no? The region that for the very first time when I read my office order reassigning me to this region, I was so scared. But this is the very region that eventually embraced me as their own. Maraming salamat sa inyo. Okay? But of course, this is the region that always fights. Never stops fighting. And of course, alam ko naman talaga na they are aiming for the whatever. This year. My apologies to the other contender. Okay? Headed, of course, by Director Roy Usal and ARD Helen Kaili. Ano ba ang nilagay ko dito? I mentioned ko pala, this is my first assignment as regional director. And I love them all. Region 11. The white team from the Davao region. Region 11. Sa forma pala. Thank you, Region 11. The next region, headed by my very good friend, the very beautiful Agadabaw yun to eh. Director Susan Donalbo and ARD Virgil Datumon. I think this is the your last as an active member of the COA family, the last anniversary, COA anniversary of Director Susan, because she is set to graduate from compulsory na. Compulsory graduation na siya. Okay. Sabi niya, this is called the South Central Mindanao Region. The Blue Team, Region 12. Thank you. And another fighting region, the region that is somehow newly created in terms of ano lang, ang pangalan lang, no? Headed by, nag-iisa lang siya palagi, no? And the other is in fighting form also, headed by Director Bato Ali Jr., the region that will never give up, the Red Team, Coa Arm Armar. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Mark. And of course, our special thanks to the last but not the least region, our host region for this year. Nakita niyo naman kung gaano ka elaborate ang kanilang mga preparations. Again, let me reminisce. This is the region which is my first assignment from my home. As assistant director, the region that has loved me so much. I know they love me until now. The region that welcomed me with so much warmth because I was away from home. Okay, headed of course by Director Jamil and Director Marisol. Hindi ko na sasabihin yung marami pa na, but I will never forget this region. Our home region for this year, the Yellow Team, thank you so much. So ladies and gentlemen, these are the delegates from the various regions in Mindanao. We wish you the best, we wish you all the luck, but remember, we are friendly to each other. All the best to all of us. Magandang umaga po.
Daghang salamat, Ma'am Bes. As Ma'am Bes said, we are very privileged to have with us one of our
member of my COA family. Ay, yung buntak sa inyong kanan. Well, I would like to congratulate in advance everyone, all the delegates from the different 6 regions. As of this point, I'd like to congratulate everyone, especially the host region under Director Jumiel for I definitely know that it will be a very successful Mindanao Palaro this year. So congratulations in advance. In behalf of the Commission proper, it would give me a great pleasure to be part of the opening ceremony of this year's COA Mindanao Palaro. Actually, last year I was not able to come here because it was then my confirmation day, including Chairman Aguinaldo was also not here. Kaya ibanat mo kuniya during my confirmation. And I would like to thank everyone for the warm welcome. This yearly event speaks not only about sportsmanship, but most importantly, it shows the commitment of every individual employee of COA to be connected and come closer with one another through sports. I am certain that everyone will showcase their best athletic skills and talents to compete with one another in the different fields of event. However, let me encourage everyone that while you compete, do not lose the opportunity to build good relationships with your opponent by also giving support to one another so that everyone will show their best in the spirit of comradeship. And lastly, I know that sport makes us all healthy and strong, but more than anything else, it gives us lessons to be more successful in life by how we accept defeat with courtesy and how we celebrate victory with humility. I wish you every success and good health. Thank you and Godspeed to everyone.
Okay, so a participant of the COA Mindanao in the regional sports competition who hereby solemnly swear to agree to adhere and uphold all conditions, agreements, rules and regulations and provisions which has been set forth by the organizers of this tournament. As a competitor of this game, I hereby swear and agree to play the game in the highest forms and standards of discipline and sportsmanship, no matter if I win or lose. What counts most is how I conduct myself and play my game in the spirit of camaraderie, sportsmanship, respect, and proper decorum at all times. I now therefore declare to preserve the tenets and precepts of a true sportsman in thought, in word, and in deed. So help me God.
Recite, repeating after me, the officials
oath, officially official's oath. We, the officially officials of the 2019 COA Mindanao Inter-Regional Sports Peace Competition, do hereby solemnly swear to perform our respective duties and responsibilities to the best of our abilities and with the highest degree of honesty and integrity and the spirit of true fair play. So help us God. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ardi Bukal.
Saya umaga po sa inyong lahat to the participants to the different competitions. Are you ready? In that case, by virtue of the superpower and authority given to me by the host region, Region 13, headed by Regional Director Osman P. Jamel, I hereby officially declare this 2019 Commission on Logic Mindanao Palaro open. Good luck, everyone.
COA Region 13, I welcome you to Caragaan, to Butuan City. About 9 years ago, we had the honor to host the same event. Then the COA Mindanao Palaro was an independent initiative of the regional directors of Mindanao, but of course with the blessing of the central office. Since 5 years ago, under the leadership of our chairman, Mike Aguinaldo, the COA Mindanao Inter-Regional Sports Fest has been made part and precursor to our annual nationwide COA anniversary celebration. Over the years, we have evolved from sports focused celebration and expanded to showcase the beauty, brains, as well as the dancing and singing talents of our own. This year, upon the initiative of our Mindanao One Commissioner, Commissioner Roland Pondo, we have integrated in our celebration our environmental concerns through the environmental protection cleanup drive that we had yesterday. For the next 2 to 3 days, we will play and compete hard as we work hard. And as hosts, we will showcase the best Caraga can offer, not only in the area of tourism, but also in the fields of arts and entertainment. We have invited famous showbiz personalities whose roots once grew in Caraga to entertain us. Tonight's activity has been made possible through the joint efforts of our personnel, your earnest cooperation, and the invaluable support of the city government of Butuan under the leadership of the Honorable Mayor Ronnie Dixie Naglada and the city tourism. Thank you.
Philippines, but there was but one. Today, its culture remains rich and preserved, and some Butuan's way of life are still enveloped with farming and fishing. In 1917, while the Manobos were busy fishing in Wawak River for food and livelihood, they found the golden pot that made history not only in Philippines, but also in the whole world.
Thank you. the world we're gonna make. However big, however small, let me be part of it all. Share your dreams with me. You may be right, you might be wrong. Bring me along to the world you see.
Gender does not dispel men. Gender awareness and development promotes women empowerment and at the same time gender equality. Here in the Commission on Audit, it ensures the different needs of men and women are addressed equally. So it's not a matter of that. It's conveying the right information of what gender awareness and development has to offer to men. After all, it's not only women who encounter problems, but also men, in the form of sexual orientation, language, ethnicity, religion, education, and status. After all, gender is for all. That would be all. Thank you.
To launch a gender-responsive program, what would it be and why?
Thank you for that question, madam. If given a chance to launch a gender-responsive program, that program would be promoting the rights of the LGBT community. I myself is a male, and I know the feeling of the LGBT community in which they think they were left behind. I as a person believe that they are capable of doing things beyond measure. I know that you are laughing right now, thinking that my answer may be responsive and that you may know or you may think that I may belong to that community. Sad to say, no. I am a straight male. But I know that if the LGBT community will be given a program or priority, I think there will be no issues to be resolved in gender issue, in gender and development. And that will be all. Thank you.
Why is that so?
Because it releases all my stress and I pour out my heart whenever I feel very overwhelmed. Even right now, I can create poems for you, but maybe next time.
Wow, I should say wow for that.
Okay, hello, candidate number 6. Is this your first time here in Butuan?
It's actually my second time.
So how do you find the people here in Butuan?
The people are always warm, as during my first visit.
So we are just warm, we're not hot. Okay, so we proceed to the picking of our questions.
Alright, Miss Candidate number 6.
Okay, so we have 2 questions left.
We only have 2. You may pick your question, Miss Candidate number 6. Alright. Miss Candidate number 6 question goes like this. Should the COA community foster awareness such as seminars, forums, and activities on third gender issues parallel to addressing women's rights and concerns? why and why not? Again, should the COA community foster awareness such as seminars, forums, and activities on third gender issues parallel to addressing women's rights and concerns? Why and why not?
Thank you. I believe that it is necessary to create awareness and fora for LGBT community as well as all other genders, because I believe that unity and harmony, the key to unity and harmony is awareness and understanding of each other's strengths and weaknesses. And as much as all rights have limits and bounds, we need to be aware that even the LGBT, even if they're strong enough to fight for their rights, there are also bounds and limits. But we should also be aware that LGBT rights are also human rights. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. COA candidate number 6.
So Mr. COA, number 6, do not have a choice at all.
Okay.
So that is your question.
This is for you.
Our last question.
Our last question is for you.
Okay, so your question is, should a separate restroom be provided for our brothers and sisters in the LGBT community? Why or why not?
Our society has already made quantum leaps in the advancement of LGBT rights, and I would like to believe that providing a separate restroom for the LGBT community would be a welcome development. However, this does not mean that it should be construed as mandatory, because I'd like to believe as well that genuine acceptance by both LGBT and the community includes the acceptance of who they were while we try to accept who they have become. Good evening.
For this time, may we request the candidates to please remain on your voice and bearing.
Yeah. you so much for having me here tonight. I'd like to thank COA for inviting me here. It's an honor to be back here in Butuan performing for Mr. and Miss COA 2019. And I'm so honored and privileged to perform here again in my hometown, because it's always been a pleasure to be here and to perform in front of you guys. So that would be all. Thank you. Thank you so much for inviting me. Maraming salamat po. Gusto ko pa? Gusto nyo ba? Sa ba? Sige, bilang taga-Dirimang ko and love kayo na po ang mga taga-Diri sa Mindanao, especially sa Butuan. One song pa para sa inyo. And I'd like to dedicate this to all of you guys and especially to our wonderful candidates. Let's give them another warm round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. I was listening to their answers backstage and I'm very impressed. They're very intelligent and very well spoken. So we have a hard time picking your winner tonight. So karon pala, congratulations sa inyo, whoever wins. And this song is for all of you. Hope you guys like this one. I found love for all of you. Time and just time right for nobody. I found love, beautiful and sweet. I never knew you were that someone waiting for me. Just kiss me when we fell in love. Now I know what it was. I will not give you up this time. Darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I am. And in your eyes, your heart is mine. Dancing in the dark with you between my arms. Barefoot on the grass, listening to our favorite song. When I saw you in that dress, looking so beautiful, I don't deserve this. Darling, you look perfect tonight. Yeah, yeah. I found a woman, someone in England I know. She shares my dreams, I hope that someday I shall know. My secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own. When you come on out, you just kiss me when we fell in love. Fighting against all odds, I know we'll be alright this time. Come and just take looking so beautiful, I don't deserve this. Darling, you are perfect tonight. Oh, 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 yeah, yeah, yeah. Thank you.
Maybe next time na lang, no? Once again, thank you, Mr. Jason Dean. So thank you, candidates.
At this juncture, let us be enlightened by an inspirational talk to be given to us by no less than the Commission on Audit's chairperson, Honorable Michael T. Aguinaldo.
Saya-saya naman. Masaya ba kayo? Yung mga taga Region 9, masaya ba kayo? Region 10? Region 11? Kami, abiha ko tata. Region 12? Ang host region, Region 13. Director Batangali, masaya ka ba? Ang barn. Oh, buti masaya kayo. Kasi, pang ilang birthday ng kuwan na to? Di ba milestone yan? Pirmahan na ng ating Pangulo yung budget. Maraming nakahanda na dahil anniversary po ng COA, milestone anniversary. First, I'd like to thank, of course, ang host region, Region 13, for doing a great job so far. Ano po, may dalawang araw pa. But, judging lang from tonight, eh, medyo mukhang masaya pa itong dalawang araw na susunod. Especially those behind this pageant, no? Hindi rin madali yung ginawa nilang yan, yung mga props, yun. Parang, yun na ata, ginawa pa ni ano eh, ni Director Jamel kanina umaga eh, na gusto mo mailaw. So yun, eh, maraming salamat. So let's give a big round of applause for Region 13. Of course, kailangan pasalamatan rin natin ang city government ng Butuan for hosting us. And especially, of course, kay Mayor Ronnie Lagdada, siya ang actually nag-sponsor ng kinakain natin ngayon kami. At ginawa niya yun kahit wala siyang MD. Pero again, maraming salamat sa city government and of course to Mayor Ronnie. We are always heartened na dahil nga ang relationship that you have with COA is really you look at us more as partners rather than just people who come in and try to make your life miserable. So maraming salamat because yun naman talaga ang gusto natin. We want to help support our audities. Hindi lang tayo naghahanap ng mali, nagtuturo rin tayo ng tama at tinutulungan rin natin sila para umunlad. So maraming salamat po. So, Mr. and Ms. Coa, mamaya palakpakan niyo talaga sila dahil mahirap yung ginagawa nila. Pag nakupo, parang ang dali ng tanong eh. Pero pag nandun ka at may ilaw at ang daming nanonood sa'yo, at medyo hindi ka rin komportable dahil masakit ang iyong cocktail dress. So, we were having fun, pero let's acknowledge the effort dahil hindi rin madaling ginagawa nyo. Ngayon, si Commissioner Pondok, naka-isa kanina. dahil kinukuha niya ang kanyang cellphone nung papasalitiin sana siya dito. Kaya, iba na lang ang gagawin niya mamaya. Hindi ko alam ano yun, pero iba yung gagawin niya mamaya. So anyway, natutuwa po ako. I think we have over 1,200 people here in Butuan for these next 2-3 days, no? I'm sure it's more, and sa sobrang dami nga, kahit na malaki tong hall na to, hindi nagkasya lahat. And so some people are actually outside watching on the screen. To those people outside, hello, hindi namin kayo nakakalimutan. Kasama pa rin kayo dito, medyo masikip lang. At actually, pinapawisan kami dito, mainit. Kaya buti na rin na sinabas kayo. But pasensya na, we'd like to accommodate everyone, pero masikip rin talaga. No? But we have all these people here. They're here to mix with everyone, to compete, but have fun. Minsan-minsan lang tayo nagkakasama ng ganito. And it's good kasi nakakasama nyo yung mga taga-ibang regions. You make new friends and renew old acquaintances. It's always good to do that. And ako, natutuwa ako personally when I see a lot of familiar faces whenever I come here. So, maraming salamat. This is for you to enjoy. Have a good time. And we hope that you also support tourism in the city of Butuan and in the region of Caraga. It's very important to support our own. So maraming salamat ulit sa inyong lahat. Oh, of course, the judges. Thank you, ma'am. Sir, thank you for taking your time. At saka alam ko medyo mahirap rin yung ginagawa nyo. Mahirap rin maging quiz. Pero maraming salamat for taking the time out and spending it with us and doing your duty as judges. So everyone, may dalawang pang araw. I'm sure there'll be a lot more fun. Bukas ng gabi, cultural night. Siguradong bongga na naman yan. Di, naalala ko kasi nung nasa Coronadal eh. Wala na ngang competition yun. Pero parang daig nyo pa yung may professional tour group na nag-perform nun. Parang tinalo pa ng Army yung performance na din. Pero hindi yung Army magaling, maraming magaling doon. Eh, lalo na ito, may competition. Ako mismo kinakabahan eh. Kasi baka mamaya, kung ano pang... Eh, kanina lang yung talent show, di ba? Yung mga costumes and all that. So, multiply that. Mas matindi yun bukas. So, anyway. Again, I hope you have a great time. This is for you because you work very hard throughout the year. So, every once in a while, masarap naman na medyo you lean back, you relax, forget all these pressures, and just have some fun. So, have fun. At mabuhay po kayong lahat.
Request.
Still request you, ma'am, sir, to
stay a bit longer
for giving of tokens to our special guests.
So we'll be giving our tokens to our judges. First, we will be giving our token to Honorable Roland C. Pondok, our beloved commissioner. So may we call on stage, sir?
Another token to be given to another plaque of appreciation is given to Honorable
Ronnie Vicente C. Lagnada, Mayor of Butuan City, for the invaluable support extended and for gracing the Fellowship Night and search for Mr. and Ms. COA 2019 COA Mindanao Palarok, given this third day of April 2019 at Almond Inland Resort, Butuan City. Signed, Attorney Osmin P. Jamil, Regional Director, Host Region. Appreciation is also given to Attorney Josefe Sorera T. for her invaluable service as Chairperson of the Board of Judges in the search for Mr. and Ms. COA 2019 Mindanao Group.
Appreciation will be given to Mr. Vicente Lagnada for his invaluable service as member of the Board of Judges in the search for Mr. and Ms. COA 2019 Mindanao Group.
Also, a plaque of appreciation is given to Cherry B. Biluan for her invaluable service as member of the Board of Judges.
Thank you.
much to our Commissioner Roland Pondo. Sir, thank you for that entertaining number.
Nag-enjoy ba kayo sa kanta ni Sir?